Hello guys, welcome to Ecolabia, driven by passion among the series of lectures on aircraft performance. In this video, we're going to discuss regarding the topic power available and maximum velocity for piston engine aircraft. You would have studied regarding different types of aircraft engines and propulsion. In aircraft performance, aircraft engines are broadly grouped into reciprocating or piston engines and turbojet engines. Reciprocating or piston engines comprises of all propeller aircrafts and mostly used in lightweight aircrafts. On the other hand, turbojet engines are used majorly in large commercial transport and in military aircrafts. Reciprocating or piston engines. The diagram of reciprocating or piston engines can be simplified as shown in figure. The thrust available curve for a reciprocating or piston engine is as shown in figure. We know power is a product of thrust and velocity. On multiplying velocity to thrust available at each point, we get corresponding points of power available. And by plotting it, we get power available curve. We see that the resulting power available curve increases with increase in velocity and becomes constant near sonic speed. At near sonic flight speeds, the tips of propeller blades encounter some compressibility problems. So, propeller engines usually don't fly above sonic speeds. Jet engines. The diagram of jet engine can be simplified as shown in figure. The thrust available curve for a jet engine is as shown in figure. We see that in turbojet engine, the thrust available is almost constant with velocity. As power is a product of thrust and velocity, the thrust being constant, we see that the power available varies linearly with velocity V infinity. Now, in order to find maximum velocity for a propeller aircraft, let's consider power required curve. If an aircraft has to fly at velocity V1, then from power required curve, we can get the value of power required to fly at velocity V1. Now, pilot adjusts his throttle such that the engine provides power available equal to power required. In figure, dashed red line illustrates partial throttle VA. In the similar manner, for identifying maximum velocity, we need to consider maximum available power from which we can try getting our maximum velocity. Intersection of maximum power curves dependent on engine and PR curves dependent on airframe gets us the maximum velocity at an altitude. For jet engines, we have discussed that we use thrust curves for finding maximum velocity. But here, for piston engines and reciprocating engines, since they are rated in terms of power, we'll be using power curves in order to find maximum velocity. The same concepts can be applied for the jet engines too. As power is a product of thrust and velocity, if we multiply velocity to thrust, we end up with power, with which profile of thrust curve only changes its magnitude to become power curves. So, maximum velocity of an aircraft is determined by high speed intersection of power available curves and power required curves. On the contrary, the minimum velocity is determined by stalling or low speed intersection of power available and power required curves. Observations. The figure shows power curves for a level unaccelerated flight. From figure, we see that Vstall is outside possible flight region. As power available should be greater than power required for flight to be possible. And in the figure, we see that Vstall lies outside this region. And From video lecture A, we saw that the angle of attack increases from right to left. With stalling, the power required curve curls back due to flow separation. We see V minimum to be at 0.2. With that, we conclude that stalling speed cannot be reached at level and accelerated flight, as V minimum is the lowest speed at which an aircraft can maintain its flight. Please do like, comment, and subscribe. We'll catch you again in the next video. Thank you.